Adam Long has been in touch to ask us how you paint the flesh of a Screamer of Tzeentch. So to do this, what you need to do first of all is undercoat your miniature, and I've chosen to do mine with Mechanica Standard Grey, but you could use Chaos Black or McCrag Blue if you wanted to. But then what you need to do is paint it entirely using Cantor Blue. Then we'll use Norn Oil to shade down the areas that we want to be darker, and then we'll start highlighting, first of all by dry brushing with Outdorf Guard Blue, then very lightly with Kalgar Blue, and then we'll finish off with a fine highlight of Fenrisian Grey. But to start out with our base coat of Cantor Blue, I'm going to use a large base brush to apply this, and what you want to do is just get some of this onto your palette so that you can thin it down with a little bit of water to ensure it's really smooth. So just a tiny bit of water, don't need very much with this. Mix it in there like that, and when you're ready, all you've got to do is start applying this all over your miniature. And with this colour, you will need to apply two thin coats. Once you've finished your base coat, it's now time to start shading down some areas using Norn Oil. And it's really up to you which parts you pick here, but I'm going to focus around these spines towards the front. And if you want this to be really dark, then apply a second coat in exactly the same way once the first one's dry. I decided to add two coats of Norn Oil to my Screamer, and with those dry, we can now begin highlighting, beginning with Outdorf Guard Blue, which I'm going to dry brush onto the miniature. Now, I'm going to be fairly heavy on these flatter parts of the body, like along here, for example, but as I get to the darker parts, I'm going to be very light, so as just to catch the raised details and edges. Once you've finished building up that colour, it's now time to move on to Kalgar Blue for much the same technique, only this time on the flatter areas, whilst you're still being fairly heavy, you want to do it a bit further down from the darker areas. So you see this way, I'm getting a nice transition from the dark to the lighter parts at the bottom there like that. And as for the darker parts, for these bits, just once again do a very light dry brush to pick out all those sharp details and features. And once that dry brush is finished, all you've got to do is add a fine highlight of Fenrisian Grey. You just want to pick out all the sharpest features and details with this. And now that highlight's been added, here we have the completed Screamer's skin, ready for those smaller details to be painted in. So the real key to this is to remember when you're doing that dry brush, in particular the heavy one, just keep it soft so you get a gradual transition from one blue to the other. So Adam, I really hope that helps you out and answered your question, and we'll see you all again soon.